that we are calling on God, we are calling on the name of the Lord, that the name of the Lord shall be released one more time over the earth. Paroga dosha makapanda bazabra pando bazabrobo eshala balababa prantala barabara prantala barababa ekayaba kadoba antoba zabro. In the name of Jesus, skatorobo zakatianta. In the name of Jesus, we are still continuing in prayer. We are still continuing in prayer, and we are praying that God's intervention will be released to stop this pandemic. We are praying that His hand will be stretched out over the face of the earth. That is why today we have taken time to seek His face, because we know that this one is beyond us. It is only by His hand. For we know that our help can only come from above. Therefore, we are praying that God's hand shall be stretched forth, yes, to stop this virus from eating the lives of men. Shall we begin to pray one more time? Zaba, makapa, barandanda, skantala baba, prantola balabalabado, deanda, dakaba, yabababa, zaza, protalaba, 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 protalabaraba. In the name of Jesus, wherever you are watching us from, we want you to join us as we pick a few of the prayer time, seeking the face of the Lord. Yes, if you fasted with us throughout the day, this is the time to engage by prayer. We are calling for help from above. We are calling for help from above, and we are asking God to reach out His hand in the name of Jesus. Barosakaka, Bagaroma Namama, Panda Bazababa, Parandanda, Skanta Baba, wherever you are watching from, we want you to engage with us. We are praying the hand of God to move mightily over this pandemic, over this condition. We are praying that God's hand shall reach out to save us from this horror. Ibaroga, Imparoba Zaza, Amaya Baba. In the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, we are praying. We are praying that God will heal those who are infected with the virus and are in hospitals. We are praying that God will heal them. May His hand reach out and touch every one of them. May their health spring up speedily according to the word of the Lord and according to Isaiah chapter 54 verse 8. Shall we begin to pray one more time? Zaba mayakaka barandanda skaba parandamba skapa barobrade balabadada mayabababa. Lord, heal thy people. Lord, heal thy people. Lord, heal thy people. Makokaba makokababa makokababa makaparababa kamparabadaba. In the name of Jesus, we are praying finally for all the leaders of the nation. We are praying for presidents. We are praying for national leaders. We are praying that the Lord will help them to be able to take timely decisions in managing the situation. May the Lord give them the best of the counsel to the glory of His wonderful name. Shall we pray? Shall we pray? Barosha makapanda baba ayabakada ayabakaba male pranta makokapa imbalabazabra palambron talabazaba imparabakaba yaya itayemba antaba. The Bible says, would you pray for men in authority? We are praying for men in authority, that we may lead a peace and a quiet and a peaceable life in all godliness. Yes, as we pray that the Lord shall bear them up, grant them the grace and the favor. Makokaba, give them the wisdom that they need. Pakaba, to make decisions. Yakaba zola masaprataba. Emparabarabazozabakabaya. Emparabokobo shada. Alem brantala bazabraba. Palambrambamba. Kampaya bakaba ronda la bazababa. Parambombas kantaba zababa. Emparabakaboza. Palembrandara bazababa. Oh shabakaba bababa. In the name of Jesus. Father, we want to give you the glory. We give you the praise for an answered prayer. We are so grateful for all that you have done for us. Thank you that you have already saved us through the blood of the cross. We bless you in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord, for your faithfulness in Jesus' name. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Wherever you are tonight, we want to warmly welcome you on behalf of the presiding apostle to our live service, communion service. The blood will speak better things tonight. Hallelujah. Amen. Who can I hear believing amen? And amen. We'll flow with the worship, we'll flow with praise. We'll have a powerful song ministry, a powerful word, and we'll sum it up with the communion. Just flow with us and have a very fruitful time. We will never leave you the same. Hallelujah. As I invite Deacon Atu to take us through the worship.
Wherever you are tonight, just connect with us in the spirit. And let's lift up the name of the Lord. Let's bless his name. And let's magnify him. The I am that I am. The only wise king. We glorify him. Oh, Father, we worship.
For his mercies shall endure ever faithful, ever sure. For his mercies shall endure, oh, ever faithful, ever sure. For his mercies, for his mercies shall endure. Hallelujah, ever faithful. Let us with a glass of hot sing. Let us with a glass of hot. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord.
For his mercy, for his
Your hands unto him wherever you are. He's awesome.
He's awesome.
Oh, we bless your name.
We bless you, Jesus.
While Shayam Fum Suni Yenendi Wama Adipa Achi Empium
Yeti
Waye Rebrewo Yachim Papa. Yachi Wapa Washayam Fum Su Eni Enzi He Wama Adipa Asayam Wawe Yachi Wale Washayam Fum Su Eni Enezi He Wama Azipa Asayam Yom Yeshira Wo Yeti Waye Rebra Wo Ohinye Yati Papa Yati
Papa
Hale.
favor. Father, we magnify your name. We crown you King of Glory. Awesome God, we bow before your throne tonight. Among the gods, there's none to be compared with you. Father, we exalt you tonight. We lift you high above every other name. For you are God. You shall reign. You shall reign. And you still reign. And you shall continue to reign. Father, we bless your name. We give you all the glory, Lord. We ascribe glory and honor to you. The glory, Father. The glory, Son. The glory, Holy Ghost. Wherever you are listening, you are hearing us, just shout, I believe in amen.
Amen.
Just shout, I believe in amen. Amen. And give the Lord a clap. Amen. Hallelujah. And celebrate Jesus.
Glory.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
All right, let's praise God. Praising the Lord always. Praising the Lord always. Praising the Lord with all your heart. Praising the Lord with all your heart. Oh, hallelujah. Praising the Lord always. Hallelujah.
Praising the Lord always.
Praising the Lord with all your heart.
Praising the Lord with all your heart.
Praising the
Lord.
Hallelujah. Praising the Lord always.
Praising the Lord
with all your heart.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Please kindly take your seats as we minister unto you. The Bible says, they that put their trust in God shall never be put to shame. He is a wonderful and a merciful Savior. And we know He is going to touch and heal our world. Hallelujah. Wonderful, merciful Savior, precious Redeemer and friend, who would have thought that a lamb could rescue the souls of men? Are you rescue the souls of men? Counselor, Comforter, Keeper, Spirit we long to embrace. You offer hope when our hearts have hopelessly lost the way.
Our heart will always cling to your word.
In you, God, I will always trust in your word. Africa will always trust in your word. Europe will always trust in your word. America will always trust in your word. The whole world will trust in your word. My heart will trust in you. Hallelujah, somebody. Amen. Give a clap offering unto Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We thank God for today. One more time, we come your way with a communion service live on Facebook. I trust the Lord that your heart is at peace. I trust God that you are at rest. In this time, very crucial time in the whole world, the best word is to encourage everybody to know that despite this demonic virus harassing the world, you shall live. You shall live and not die. And this day, I want to share a word with you, and then we'll pray for our nation Ghana. Today, everybody pray for this nation Ghana, and we keep praying for Ghana because it's so important to pray for this nation. I'll pray with you shortly. We'll pray for the whole nation, Ghana, and the world. So let's talk about a few things, a few important things, and then we take it from there. Hallelujah. Shall we pray? Father, we thank you for your word. Speak something to us in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Now, I will share with you about how to deal with the spirit of death. How to deal with the spirit of death. Why am I saying this? Because people are afraid to die. People fear to die. And we must deal with the root of the fear. Okay? So I'll share with you the next probably 20 minutes how to deal with the spirit of fear shortly. Now, what is death? The Bible says that James 2:26 says that for as the body without the spirit is dead, so faith without works is dead also. So, what is death? The body without the spirit is death. Now, there are two kinds of death. You have spiritual death and physical death. In spiritual death, it is also called the separation of your spirit from God, from God's presence. That is called spiritual death. Okay? So, we won't tackle much of that today. Okay? Now, where did death come from? The origin of death. Why are people dying? Why do we even die? Okay, physically. The scripture is Genesis 2 from 15 to 17. It says that, and the Lord took the man and put him in the garden of Eden to tend and keep it. And the Lord God commanded the man, saying, of every tree of the garden you may freely eat, but of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, you shall not eat. For in the day that thou eatest thereof, thou shalt surely die. So death actually began from the Garden of Eden through man's disobedience. Man disobeyed God, and death was the penalty of that disobedience. And that death that man suffered actually affected the whole human race. So Romans 5:12 says that, wherefore as by one man sin, for by one man sin entered into the world, and death by sin, and so death passed upon all men, for that all have sinned. So death came into the whole world through one man called Adam. Hallelujah. So the whole world is in sin, the whole world is dying because of one man's disobedience. What is sin? What is sin? Sin is disobedience to God's commandment. And that is why we are dying. That's why we die spiritually and we died physically. Every spiritual thing that happens spiritually manifests physically. So when man dies spiritually, Okay, that also resulted in his physical death. And today we keep dying physically. Right. Now, Romans 6:23, the wages of sin is death. The penalty of sin is death. So the death we are experiencing in the whole world from Adam's time started from sin. Sin. The wages of sin is death. This time we must pray that God could forgive the whole world. Probably something wrong is happening somewhere. There's a sin happening somewhere in the world. That's why this kind of death is happening. We have to pray for forgiveness. The whole world must come and say, Lord, we forgive us for our sin. Hallelujah. That sin, that common sin, it must leave. Amen. Okay, so sin results in death. And 1 Corinthians 15:56 says that the sting of death is sin. And the strength of sin is the law. When you break the law, you have sin. And when you sin, death will certainly come your way and kill you. Hallelujah. Now, when Jesus Christ came, he dealt with sin. To deal with death, he must deal with sin. So Jesus came and dealt with the problem of sin. So we are told in 1 Peter 2, verse 24. 1 Peter 2:24 says that, who himself bore our sins in his own body on the tree, that we, having died to sins, might live for righteousness, by whose stripes ye were healed. So Christ took our sins on the tree. The cross was the solution to man's sinful nature. And today still is the cross. I present to you the power of the cross. There's power in the cross. Jesus dealt with our death problem, our sin problem, by dying on the cross. So if you want to deal with sin and death, the only antidote is the cross. Is the cross. Is the cross. Now, Hebrews 9:26 says that, for then must he often have suffered since the foundation of the world. But now, once in the end of the world, hath he appeared to put away sin by the sacrifice of himself. So Jesus Christ sacrificed himself for what reason? To put away sin, to deal with the sin problem of man, which caused death. Hallelujah. Now, it's so important that we should understand that if the whole world is afraid of death today, death is happening everywhere. How should we handle death? I'll come there. But we must deal with sins. Today, the whole world, we have moved from God's way. We are doing our own thing. We are changing sexes. We are doing this. We are doing that. Several things happen in the world. What do you expect? What do you expect? What do we expect? Moving from God's direction into our own way. Certainly, sin and death, they are connected. Once you sin, death will come. So we need to come back to the drawing board. The root of death is sin. We must deal with the sin problem. And Jesus Christ came to take away our sins on the cross. Like it or not, that's the antidote to the death problem. Hallelujah. Now we read in 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 10. 2 Timothy 1:10. And it says that, but it's now made manifest by the appearing of our Savior Jesus Christ, who hath abolished death and hath brought life and immortality to light. So Jesus Christ came to abolish death by carrying our sin on the cross. So death can be dealt with, both spiritual and physical, by Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. There's a link between death and the devil. And I'll show you, there's a close link between death and the devil. Where there's death, find out, Satan may be present. When death is increasing somewhere, find out, Satan may be present. So I'll give you a scripture shortly, and then we continue. 1 John 3:8. 1 John 3:8 says that, he that committeth sin is of the devil. Now, so sin and the devil are committed, okay? There's so much connection between sin and the devil. And therefore, sin and death. And therefore, the devil and death, okay? Now, so he that sins is of the devil. So sin actually was brought into the world by the devil. Amen. He deceived man, and man entered into it. Now, more importantly, I want to share this with you, that death is a person. Death is not just a thing. It's a person. Death is a person. I'll give you scriptures again. We believe that death is not just a thing. Death is a person. We must deal with that person called death. It's a living thing. It's a living being. It's a living being. And we see the scripture in Revelation 6, verse 8. The book of Revelation 6, verse 8. And it says that, "And I looked, and behold, a pale horse, and his name that sat on him was death." Don't be surprised. Death is a person. Death is not a thing. It's not a thing. Death is a living being. Because John saw that. He saw somebody on a horse, on a pale horse. And his name, his, is a personal pronoun. Not it, it's his. His name that sat on him was death. And hell followed with him. And power was given unto him, unto them, over the earth, the fourth part of the earth, to kill with sword and with hunger and with death and with the beasts of the earth. So, what we are saying, that people are dying everywhere, it's not just a thing, it's a person. Death is a living being. It's a living being. Hallelujah. And we shall deal with death tonight. We pray for the world and pray for the nation Ghana as well. Death is a living being. It's a person. And death was giving power, as we just read, to kill with hunger. And that is hunger, right? Famine. And with what? With the sword, instruments of death, okay? Now, if you read again, we see that death is a person in the Bible. I can't give you all the scriptures. But for your own sake, you can read the book of Revelation 20, 13 to 14, where we are told that death was cast into the lake of fire. Death was judged. God judged death. How can you judge death? If it's an it, you can't judge it. Death was a person who was judged. Okay, so Revelation 20, 13 to 14, and was thrown in the lake of fire. Death is a person. Now, how does death function? What instruments does death use to destroy people? Number one, fear. Fear is the number one instrument of death. So, this called modus operandi of death. How does death function? How does it function? One, if death is coming to you, he will put fear in you. Fear is a dangerous doorway of death. Once you can block fear, you can block the person called death. 2 Timothy 1, verse 7. 2 Timothy 1, verse 7. And it says that, "For God has not given us the spirit of fear." So, fear is a spirit. It's a demon. That's why I said that death itself is a spirit. Fear too is a spirit. It's not an it. It's a being. So don't be afraid. Don't ever be afraid, okay? For God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of power, of love, and of sound mind. Fear is a, it's not the thing. Fear is a spirit. It's a demon. And fear is the key, the main doorway of the devil, of death. If death is coming, you come through fear. Once he creates a scenario for you to be afraid, he gets you. So take note. That's why we keep preaching. Don't be afraid. This season, don't be afraid. Amen. Amen. COVID will not kill you. You will never die. Believe you won't die. The whole world, don't ever entertain fear. You see, when fear comes, it breaks your immunity. Your immune system gets broken down. So then you start dying. So don't ever be afraid. Resist death. Fear not. Tell somebody, fear not. Tell yourself, I'm not afraid. Amen. Because Hebrews 2, 14, 15, Hebrews 2, 14, 15 says that, "For as much then as the children are partakers of flesh and blood, he also himself likewise took part of the same, that through death, he might destroy him that had the power of death." That is the devil, "and deliver them who through fear of death, were all their lifetime subject to bondage." If you fear death, you'll be in bondage. You will be in bondage. You are bound. Hey, you don't know what to do. Should I eat this? Any place you go, you are afraid you will die. You'll be in bondage. So don't be afraid. Say, "I'm not afraid." Number two, physical weapons. of war. Death uses what? Physical weapons of war to kill people, like sword. We read in the book of Revelation 6, verse 8. The book of Revelation 6, verse 8 says that, "And I looked, and behold, a pale horse, and his name that sat on him was Death, and hell followed with him. And power was given unto him over the fourth part of the earth to kill with sword." So Death was given power to kill with sword. So what is sword? It's a death instrument. Okay? And with hunger. Okay? And with death and so on and so forth. So weapons of war, like guns. Guns are weapons of war. The sword. Okay? People killing, people slashing people's throats. It's all part of the deal. Death uses instruments of war. Hallelujah. And death can even use famine. Famine, like now that there's lockdown in many countries, what do you expect? People will be hungry. They'll be hungry. And even hunger can kill. In some countries where there's so much famine, people die easily. So take note of that. The death can use instruments of war, instruments of death, like what? Like physical weapons, okay? And then sickness and disease. Death uses what? Sickness and disease to kill people. And one of the things is that the virus is a sickness. It brings sickness and disease, and then you die. Amen. It's a person. Death is a person. May God have mercy upon us. May God have mercy upon us. That's why Jesus Christ came to condemn sin and sickness. He healed the sick. By his stripes, you were healed. Now, how do you secure yourself from death? How do you secure yourself from death? Amen. Number one, engage God as your refuge. Engage God as your refuge. Engage God as your refuge. Hallelujah. Engage God as what? Your refuge. Psalm 91 from verse 1, we shall pray very soon. He that dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide in the shadow of the Almighty. I will say unto the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in Him will I trust. You know a refuge, a place, a hiding place, a secure place, a place you go and you can't be killed. It's a refuge. So engage God as a refuge. I thank God for our president that he said we should all fast and pray. What is the reason for that? God is our refuge. Americans also prayed, God, be our refuge. I saw some clip about Venezuela. People on the street, they were on the floor, kneeling, and they were praying. You see? And when we engage God as a refuge, God will come as a refuge. So this season, we should engage God as what? Our refuge. Verse 3, surely he shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee with his feathers, and thy wings shall thou trust. Verse 5, thou shalt not be afraid of the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day. Amen. So this is what God shall keep us as our great refuge. Hallelujah. Now when you read the book of Psalm 9 verse 9, it says that the Lord also will be a refuge to the oppressed, a refuge in times of trouble. So in this time of trouble, God can be our refuge. Hallelujah. Our refuge is God. Amen. Amen. Bible says that the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous runs into it and they are safe. When you go to God, He's a strong tower and we are safe. May you be safe in God. As we keep on praying for God to intervene, may we be safe in God. Hallelujah. So, first thing, take God as a refuge. Number two, things you do is that take instructions. Take instructions. Use common sense. Take instructions. Proverbs 5 verse 23. Proverbs 5 23 says that he shall die without instruction, and in the greatness of his folly he shall go astray. Now, instructions that we're given that we should avoid coming together so much. It's an instruction. If you ignore it, you will die. You will die. Proverbs 5 23. He shall die without instruction. If you don't take instruction, don't ever come too close. You may die. So an instruction can keep you from death. They say that wash your hands. They say that sanitize your hands is an instruction. If you don't take it, death will come to you. So we are using twofold means to attack, spiritual and physical. God, our refuge, and then using what common sense. Instructions. Hallelujah. I read something in the book of Proverbs 10, verse 17. For he is in the way of death that keepeth instruction. If you don't keep instruction, he is in the way of life that keeps instruction. If you want life, keep instruction. Keep instruction. Some countries have had a lockdown. Nigeria has had it today, right? And it's going on. And that's a way to do it. That is the way. Lockdown means don't go anywhere. Take instructions and leave. You want to leave, take instruction. I was at the beach over on Sunday to just look at what's happening in town. Sakumono Beach. I was amazed that Ghanaians don't know what is happening. Many are not aware. They don't read. I don't know. Because I saw several cars. Crowd at the beach. I say, hey. So all this is that's happening. People don't know. Government has a big job to do to educate people. Because this thing can kill. It can kill within a short time. One day, 1,000 people are dying. And can Ghana contain? We need God. We need mercy. But we must take instruction. So take instruction. Let me say this. There's a proverb in Ghana. It says that Kona Mokoni Echen Shan Miwafi Yenu Kep Kemoma say. Se who say obi aboju e shia. Sanso fase wunchen. I can't speak the heavy, otherwise I'll wrap the heavy right now. If you see somebody's beard burning, get some water and place it by you, because next time it will be you. It will be you. So we have to be wise and see what others are doing and take instruction. When David was going to be killed by Saul, what did he do? He fled. David fled. He didn't pray. David didn't pray. He fled from Saul. That is wisdom, common sense. When Paul was about to be killed, what did he do? He fled. They took him into a basket. Paul was put in a basket across the wall and he fled. If you fear death, if you see death coming, will you go and get it? No, be wise. Wise up. Run away. Number four, last one. Keep your mouth from speaking evil. First Peter 3, verse 10. Keep your mouth. He that will love life and see good days, let him refrain his tongue from evil. If you want to live, don't say, I'll have COVID. Don't confess it. Don't say, hey, it's coming. Hey, I'll have it. If you say it, you have it. If you confess, you have it. So check your mouth. Lock your mouth. I said lock your mouth. Lock your beak. And don't confess COVID in your life. It will come. Last scripture, it says in Proverbs 18, verse 21. And say after me. Death and life are in the power of the tongue, and they that love it shall eat the fruit thereof. Proverbs 18:21. Death and life are in the power of the tongue, and they that love it shall eat the fruit thereof. You see, if you want to die, speak death. You want life, speak life. What you say is what you have. 50 minutes more to close. But I want you to take note of all the points I've given you. Death uses fear to arouse us. Don't be afraid. Hallelujah. And make sure that you take God as your refuge. Let's pray for God to give us protection in Ghana, the world. And then use common sense. If you see death coming, run away. That's where the quarantine comes in. And let's not disobey the quarantine. Let us all try and obey, otherwise death will come. Lastly, what do you do? You try to speak life into your life. Stand on your feet right now, wherever you are. The shuffles, the home cells, wherever you are meeting, stand on your feet. But be wise, separate a little bit, and let's pray in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Lord. 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 Instruments. Oh, thank you, Lord. Paroni shake. Say thank you, Lord. I thank you. I bless you, Lord. I give you glory. I give you honor. I give you praise. I adore you. Baro shikalorian de salabakuta sikende. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I give you glory. I give you glory. Thank you. Just thank the Lord. In Jesus' precious name. Masu Taki Bazaka. Gondaraba Shandaba. Ilaba Sandaraba Zandaba Zazaka. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you so much, Lord. Now, we are going to pray for Ghana. We are praying to secure our borders. May the Lord have mercy on Ghana. And by extension, the whole world. We are praying for a kind of intervention in the whole world. Italy is suffering suffering so much. The casualty rate is very high. May God have mercy on Italy, the U.S. May God visit Spain. It's also going very up. The deaths are rising. Now, lift your voice and let's pray for Spain, Italy, U.S., Iran. Lord, visit. Lord, intervene. Come on, pray. Lord, come on, pray. Shaba, Zitosa, Mareto Sande, Marco Shenda. Lord, intervene. 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 Intervene, Lord. Intervene, Lord. Intervene, Lord. Baranda. 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 Laka saka paranda she. Le saka tarabalo sheke. Ola senta baba. Baranda luka baka. Lord, intervene in Ghana. Save this nation. Save other nations. Baro se kaba shanda baba. We pray, Lord, for wisdom. We pray for wisdom. We pray for protection. Visit Spain. Visit Italy.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Now, I said death is a person, it's a demon. We are binding the demon of corona.
Jesus.
That virus right
yes,
now.
Yes, Lord.
It must go back to where it came from.
Jesus.
Name. It's a person. It's a being.
Mm.
Now say, Lord.
Lord.
In the name of Jesus.
Of Jesus.
We come against the demon.
Demon
of coronavirus.
Of coronavirus.
Right now.
Right now.
And we cast it.
And we cast it
into the sea.
Into the sea.
Now.
Now.
Go.
Now go.
Now.
Now.
Go.
Go.
Now.
Now.
Go.
Go.
Now.
Now.
Go.
Go.
Pray right now.
Kababa palabra dadaba kababa bare yandaba ba.
We come against you coronavirus, corona demon. We bind you and cast you to the sea. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. We subdue you out of this nation, out of Italy. Live our wealth. 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 In Jesus' precious name. Now, the cross is a solution spiritually. The cross in the blood. Now, we are praying that the blood shall be sprinkled over the nations.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, show up in the cross.
Yes, Lord.
Show up with your blood right now. In all the nations. Come on, pray shortly. Let the cross of Jesus prevail in nations. Prevail, 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 prevail. Prevail. Let the cross prevail. Let the cross prevail. Let the cross prevail. Rule the nations, Lord. Intervene, Lord, with healing. Those who are sick, heal them, Lord. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. The Son of righteousness shall arise
yes, Lord.
With healing in his wings.
Jesus.
May God heal those who are sick right now.
Yes, Lord.
Wherever they might be in the world.
Yes,
may
Lord.
God touch them. I will pray the last prayer. Lord,
Jesus,
touch them.
Jesus.
Those who are sick, those who have got,
touch, Lord.
Got it.
Touch,
Lord, touch them.
Touch, Lord.
Those who have been infected, may Lord touch them. Lord, touch them right now. Intervene, oh God, in our world. Save our world. Save our world. In the name of Jesus. Thank you for this nation, Ghana. Today we spend time to pray for Ghana, Father. And we pray again for Ghana. Secure our borders. Secure everyone. From the president to the parliamentarians to the ministers of state to everyone in this nation. To traders, market women and men, Lord. To drivers, to nurses, the doctors. All those at the forefront of fighting this virus. We pray that your hand shall be upon them. Lord, preserve their lives.
Jesus.
Lord, preserve their lives.
Jesus.
Preserve this nation.
Yes, Lord.
You demonic spirits of corona, we bind you and cut
Jesus name.
From this nation.
Yes, Lord.
May this nation be preserved.
Yes, Lord.
In Jesus' precious name.
Yes, Lord.
Across all the nations of the world.
Yes.
May God's healing come upon the nations.
Yes, Lord.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Give God some clap offering now. Hallelujah. Amen. 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 We thank God. We give you praise. Amen. We have 10 minutes more to close. But those of us who are here, those of you who are in the home cells, take your offering. Let's give an offering to God in your home cells right now. Okay, we'll take communion shortly. Take communion. So bring the communion right now. If you are there in your home cells, okay? The home cells, the families, take your communion right now. In Jesus' precious name, amen. Oh, the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. Oh, the blood
of Jesus.
The blood of Jesus. Oh, the blood
of Jesus. It washes white as snow.
And it sanctifies.
Oh, the blood of Jesus.
Oh, the blood. Oh, the blood.
Jesus.
Oh, the blood.
Oh, the blood of Jesus. It washes white as snow.
We are doing this because our churches and our sheepfolds, our homes and families have been instructed to take communion every Wednesday. We do it here in church. But now that we are in our homes, we can take communion. If you want to take communion, you need to get born again first. You need Jesus Christ to come into your heart to avoid this spiritual death. Hallelujah. Wherever you want Jesus in your heart, you want to get born again today, please say this after me. Say, Lord Jesus, I believe you died on the cross for my sin. You rose again on the third day. I confess you as my Lord and my personal Savior. Come into my heart, Lord Jesus, and save me today. Amen. Hallelujah. Now you can take the communion, take the body of Jesus. Let's pray. Say, Lord Jesus, in the night you were betrayed, you took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and said, take, eat. This is my body broken for you. Do this to remember me. Lord Jesus, I remember you as my Savior. I remember you as my healer. I remember you as my provider. I remember you as my risen King. I remember you as my ascended Lord. I remember you as my ruling King. I remember you as my soon coming King. Jesus, heal my body. Service my body. Touch my life as I eat your body. In Jesus' name. Amen. Let's do it right now. Now take the wine and say, Lord Jesus, in the same manner, you took the cup and said, this is my blood of the New Testament shed for you for the forgiveness of sin. Drink it, all of you, to remember me. By your blood, you overcame Satan. As I drink your blood, I overcome satanic entities. I overcome the coronavirus power. In the name of Jesus, I shall not die, but live. In Jesus' name, amen. Let's drink now. There's power in the blood. Thank you. Thank you for the cross.
Thank you for the cross, Lord.
Let's sing this song right now.
Thank you for the price you paid.
Jesus died for us.
Bearing all my sin and shame.
Thank you, Jesus.
In love you came and gave amazing grace. Thank you for this love. Thank you for the meal presents. Wash me in your cleansing.
Lift up and sing out. Sing out.
Now all I know, your forgiveness and grace. Worthy is the Lamb.
Seated
on the throne. We crown you
now
with many.
You reign
victorious.
You reign victorious.
lifted up high and lifted up. Jesus, Son of God, the darling of heaven, crucified. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb.
Give them all the clap offering now. Hallelujah. Clap for Jesus. We need to pray. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. For all those who are watching live in our home cells, in the families, as we instructed, you are still having church. So take your offering wherever you are, and the head of the family or the head of the sheepfold will receive the offering, and he knows what to do. Hallelujah. Amen. So take your offering right now. Let's get to the Lord in Jesus' name. Lift it up. Now, we also have Momo number on the screen. So look at the screen. You don't have cash. You can Momo it on the screen, and it will really come to God's glory, to use it for God's work. Amen. So Momo it. It is for church. Now, know that you do it as a discipline and as a way of serving your God. Amen. Father, we thank you and bless you for the seed we sow. We give you praise in Jesus' name. Amen.
What are you turning to wine? Open the eyes of the blind. No one like you. None like you. Into the darkness you shine. Say, into the darkness you shine. Out of the ashes. No one like you, no one like you, none like you. Our God is greater, our God is greater,
our God is stronger.
God, you are higher than any other. Our God is awesome in power.
Our God,
our God is greater,
our God is greater,
hey.
Our God is stronger.
God, you are higher than any other. Our God is awesome in power.
Our God.
What are you turning to wine? Open the eyes of the blind.
There's no one like you.
None like you.
None like you.
Into the darkness you shine.
Shine.
Out of the ashes we rise.
Ashes we
no
rise.
One like
no
you.
No one like you.
No one.
Not like you.
Our God is greater.
Our God is greater. Our God is stronger.
God, you are so
God,
high.
You are
higher than any other.
Our God is healer.
Awesome in power.
Say, our God.
Our God is greater.
Our God is greater.
Hey.
Our God is stronger.
You are so
high. You are higher than
you are higher.
Our God is healer.
You're awesome in power.
Our God.
And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, who can stand again?
And if our God
come
is for us,
declare it wherever you are. Come on. Hey.
And if our God is with us,
and if our God is with us,
and if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us?
Oh.
And if our God is with us, what can stand again?
And if our God
is for us, then who could ever stop us?
And if our God is with
us, and if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, what can stand again?
Awesome time. Please let's stretch forth our hands as we bless our offerings. Glorious Father, we want to acknowledge you. We thank you for all that we have received, even in your presence. Thank you that death is defeated in the name of Jesus Christ. And Father, as we connect to your word, we pray, oh God, that you allay our fears and let faith arise in us to confront the challenges. We bless you for every seed that we have sown. Even tonight, we ask that you multiply the seeds we have sown. And Father, give us a turnaround in our financial destinies. In the name of Jesus Christ, we give you the praise. We give you the glory for an answered prayer. And let the saints say a big amen. Amen. As we receive the presiding to give us the benediction.
Hallelujah. Yeah, that is Laughing Chapel Facebook Live. God bless you for being with us. Our members who are in the homes and those of you who are having sheepfolds, may God bless you. Keep the spirit up. We are not sure what will be happening between now and the weekend, but just in case there's a lockdown, amen, we won't stop coming to you live on Facebook. It will still happen. Hallelujah. So we shall keep on having Facebook Live until whatever is happening is over. So connect with us. Hallelujah. And the Lord shall bless you. Let me tell you something before I close. Christianity is a personal word, relationship with God. So whether we are here or not, maintain your spiritual life. Every morning, wake up and have your quiet time. Read the devotionals that we have even sent to you. We bought this whole year. We are reading devotionals. We are reading the Bible reading plan. Make sure that you are a good Christian. It's a test for you, a test case for every Christian. When we are not meeting, what do you do? So maintain your Christianity, your quiet time, your quiet time, your Bible reading. Amen. And the Lord shall be with you. God willing, Sunday, 9 a.m., we shall come your way again with church service. This is called virtual church service. It's a service on online. And the Lord shall be a blessing to us. God bless you as we close. Wherever you are, close your eyes, the sheepfolds, wherever. May God keep you. May God strengthen you. May the Lord himself be with you. You shall not die but live to declare the words of God. May the blood of Jesus Christ be upon you. May the cross be a protection over your life. In Jesus' name. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship with the Holy Spirit be this now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, God's goodness and mercy are following us all the days of our lives, and we are dwelling in the presence of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. God bless you. Have a wonderful session in your homes. Enjoy the day. Amen. I'll see you again Sunday. Bye-bye. Bye.